Okay, to my dear Ganandel, Jean and Nancy. You must think I've lost my mind, but I will let you into a secret. My cousin was named Ganandel at birth, and that is what I have always called her. After we vomited our way to Australia, on the Sorrento ship to Australia for 7 weeks, our father's youngest... On a Sorrento ship to Australia for 7 weeks, our father's youngest brother, Laurie, was at the dock to meet us all. After a warm welcome, he pointed at each of us and gave us our new Australian names. And that was how Ganandel became Nancy. So you ask, who the fuck is Jean? Well, Nancy never really forgave our uncle for not naming her Jean. That was her favourite name. So Ganandel, Nancy, Jean, we all love you no matter what we call you, and I'm sure you've been called many other names. We were both born in Ulm, Germany, which is unknown to most people. The only saving grace for us was that Albert Einstein was also born in the same town, and I came to the conclusion we would both end up very smart with a high IQ as we drank the same water as Albert Einstein. Nancy and I shared a bed when we first came to Australia, and that cemented... Oh, there's plenty to come, Nancy and I shared a bed when we first came to Australia, and that cemented our journey as cousins and friends. Our family spent every weekend together and many very warm nights at St Kilda Beach, but Nancy was never allowed to go in the water past her ankle.
Why?
And has never done so since. But after 69 years, earlier this year, Aria sent me a video on the beach of the Gold Coast. And there was Ganandel, so brave and so excited. And she ventured into the ocean to her knees. During our 10 years, Nancy always stood out with her blonde teased hair, high heels, amazing clothes, black eyeliner, a fag hanging out of her mouth, and bright pink lipstick. She was the original Widgie and the Jewish Pamela Anderson. She was always a star, and although she drives me crazy her age, she still looks gorgeous today. She recently discussed with me if she should have some cosmetic surgery before her 70th. After a lot of convincing, I said to her, Nancy, you can do whatever you want, I'm not judgmental, but you're going to end up with a young face and an alter tuchus. She liked it so much, and hopefully that's the end of that. Nancy was adamant she did not want to celebrate her milestone 70th birthday and said she was going to hide on the day. I told her if she does not answer her phone or open the door, I would somehow get in through her window. And I phoned her and texted her daily, giving her a countdown of how many days until we're 70. The only reply I ever received every time I sent her a text was, fuck off.
So Nancy, so Nancy.
Both Nancy and her siblings, and myself and my siblings, both lost our mothers at a very, very young age. And I convinced her that each year is a gift, and it is important for her to celebrate every birthday. Nancy had a difficult time, along with her family, caring for her gorgeous dad for many years, and was an amazing, wonderful daughter. Along with Ariel and the boys and the rest of the family, they did everything to ease his condition as best they could. Uncle Jack could always rely on my dad, his brother, to come to help him any time, day or night. Uncle Jack adored his children and every one of us, and he was so warm and loving to all of us. Nancy married Ariel in Israel and settled in Australia. First Simon was born. The day she arrives home, I receive a phone call. She's been home for 5 minutes and she rings me and she's hysterical. I don't know what she's saying, so I get in my car and I speed to her place, not even knowing what happened. Anyone who knows Nancy, she ain't the most organised person. Simon was hollering. Nancy was crying. So I said to her, maybe we give him a bottle. I haven't got any bottles, she said. Maybe we give him a dummy. I haven't got any dummies. How about if we change his nappy? I've only got a couple left. Oh, Nancy, what's wrong with you? I drove to the chemist to buy all the supplies Simon required, and after several hours, he eventually settled down. Lior, you were the lucky one. By the time you were born, Mum had some idea of what she was doing. Nancy has always had a very even temperament, not. On any given day, she can wake up as Mary Poppins, but by the end of the day, she's morphed into Charles Manson. She is never short of a word and always has a story to tell. If only she hadn't wagged school so much, she would have learned the word crazy. While she tells me every single detail of every single story, I have done the dishes, the washing, made a bed, gone for a 5 kilometre walk, and she is still talking. Thank God for Panadol. However, she can always be relied on to tell a great story and make me laugh. Unfortunately, Nancy does suffer from a debilitating ailment called chronic lateness. Time management is not her forte, but she is always forgiven for her lame excuses as she runs into a restaurant schwitzing and stressed from rushing to get there. After all these years, she is yet to arrive early for any arrangements. Nancy, thank you for always providing me with the use of your aqua car. Anyone that had an aqua car in return. Yeah, I'm about to say it. With the use of your aqua car in return for lying. In return for lying or assisting you with an alibi for your parents once you discovered boys. Okay, for those of you who may not know this, Nancy has two homes. One is this beautiful home we're in now, but unfortunately most of her time is spent at her second home called Chadston. Buying, returning. She is every shopkeeper's nightmare. Yeah. So Chadston completes the hotel they are building, there's no doubt she will be first to make a book. Both myself and my sisters love nothing more than when we all get together and reminisce about growing up, and we love speaking English together. We have so many laughs when we come up with some of the expressions our parents used to say to us. Remember,
Okay.
behind you.
I'm not a religious person. But I firmly believe poor eyesight in older age is a gift Hashem gives us for a reason.
Yeah.
Nancy, listen.
Yeah.
With poor vision, you cannot see any wrinkles, sagging boobs, or dropped ass. And even better, the compass on your bathroom scale is not any good. Some women are afraid of waking up with extra wrinkles, those fat wing arms, or worse still, a menopause moustache. But in reality, we are dressed to be healthy and enjoy life. Ganendala, you were always beautiful and still are. You have a huge time art which you share with everyone you meet. Nancy has always been a devoted sister to Rachel and Lee and their families, a wonderful wife to Ariel when she's not nagging, a generous and caring mother to Simon and Rachel and Lior and Haley, and absolutely adores her 5 grandchildren. She is a loyal friend and a special cousin to Rosie, Simon and myself and our extended families. Nancy, 70 represents a lot of living and many bumps in your journey to this stage of your life. All of your experiences equal the sum total of who you are today. Let your eyes look forward, there's no turning back. So relax, focus clearly on the road ahead, and keep enjoying your life with your wonderful family and friends. You are truly blessed. Mazel tov, l'chaim, and I love you.
Yeah.